Happy Mercedesing. In this video, we're going to be talking about the fuel distributor again. If any of my videos helped you repair your car, then please hit the button thanks. If you, yeah, you want to be the first one to watch my videos as they are fully uploaded, then become a supporter of the channel. And if you want to watch the service manuals, then become a donor. Thanks.
Well, until now I've been teaching you everything I was reading about the Ke-Jetronic, studying it and so on. But now I want to tell you that there are some things there in the manuals which are not as they are supposed to be in reality. Something there is not as it is supposed to be. Let's say it wrong. Something is wrong there. I'm going to explain that afterwards. But now, I want to tell you how I came up to the idea for this video. I came up with the idea to make this video while I was sitting on the flush toilet, believe it or not, watching at a faucet which was dripping. As I was watching the rhythm of the drops dripping. This must be the fuel flowing out of the fuel distributor while it's on idle. I will explain why this is necessary and why it's so important. Then I took my syringes, I took the cell phone using a stopwatch and started measuring the quantities which I got in 1 minute. In each manual it says that if a fuel distributor is accurate, or it is as it is supposed to be, you must get 4 milliliters of fuel. For the cast iron, for older models, even 6. For the newer versions of the fuel distributor, 4. Whereby the difference between all the cylinders must be 10%. Well, to tell you the truth, 10% for full throttle or the full load is barely noticeable. It's barely noticeable, and even for partial load, but 10% for idle is too much. 5 is the upper limit. Just to make a comparison, ask a trumpet player what is easier for him, How is it easier for him to play? Loud or quiet? You will be astonished when you hear the answer. This means that ideal for idle is 2.5%. And that is a single drop. Believe it or not. I'm going to prove you now.
2 drops.
Here, what you see between these two marks, this one and this one, it's 0.1 milliliter. So, in order to get even higher accuracy, you would have to find some kind of a measuring device that would divide this much. Here. This much to 10. Well, if you find that kind of a device, good luck. Then you can get even higher accuracy and better readings for the idle, and then you can mount the injectors and do it.
Whoever thinks he can get even higher accuracy in percentage, he would have to mount the injectors for this purpose. That's why cleanliness plays a huge role when washing the fuel distributor. At first place, the cleanliness of the filters in the distributor itself. That's why the fuel distributor has to be sterile. If you are a perfectionist and if you want to get a max out of your KE. That's why I stress again, do not use ethanol containing fuel. That is going to destroy your fuel distributor. The fuel distributor is not predicted to be opened each year or twice a year. It's predicted to last forever. So, although there are people saying that there is a lifetime of a fuel distributor, I don't agree with that, to be honest with you. Because the biggest punishment for the fuel distributor is for it not to work. Because it has all those filters inside. As long as gasoline flows through the fuel distributor and through those filters, gasoline lubricates it. I mean, all the filters. It lubricates the piston, the plunger inside. And it's cleaning. Gasoline cleans as well. And it's cleaning good way. And as long as you then use some other types of fuel, like LPG, for example, you are going to make a hell of it. And again, avoid ethanol containing fuel like hell. If you want to preserve your both K as well as KE Jetronic cars. And now, as I was speaking about
those things I do not agree with in the manuals. For each car, it says in the manual, no matter which engine it is, M110, M102, 103, 104, 116, 17, 119. No important. It's not important. It says 100 milliliters, you must get the quantity on full load, 30 on partial load, and 4 on idle. Okay. Now, the strongest engine, let's say it like that, concerning liters, let's say it like that, was W116, 6.9. Now, divide 6.9 to 8, and you will see what you are going to get. And the weakest one was 1.8 for 190E. And then we divide 1.8 to 4. And now, see the difference? Well, somewhere it's the same, no matter if you divide it with 8 or with 4. Because, for example, 250 milliliters is 250 milliliters, no matter if it's divided with 4 or with 8 or with 6. So, as for the service manuals, they have never, at the dealership, they have never disassembled a fuel distributor. They do not know how to do that, even in that time while they were working and repairing the cars. It just says, if the numbers are not reached, if the nominal value is not reached, then replace the fuel distributor. So they order the fuel distributor by your VIN number or engine code, let's say better like that, and you get it from the factory calibrated, and that's it. So they do not know how to do that. Okay, I don't want to say that any expert that knows better than people at the dealerships, but this is the fact. Because they service the car, they just replace parts. They do not repair them. And that's a huge difference. Okay. So, I believe this would be enough. And you, my dear, what do you say? Come on. Send a kiss. And that would be bye-bye for now. So, if you liked this video,
please consider subscribing to our YouTube channel and click the bell to be notified when we post new videos.
Then, I would kindly ask you not to hit the button skip ad. That is going to help me a lot. And till some next one,
hyper-Mercedesing. Bye.